So, we have people here, and we have them everywhere, okay? And I know lots of them, and they're not just people in the New Age. They're people in Christianity, they're people in Islam, they're people in Judaism, they're people all over this place. They're atheists who are trying so hard, so hard, so hard to eliminate themselves of all their hate. And they can't do it. You can't do it. You can't. And you do it anyway, and you put up this phony wall that says, I will not hate, when you're feeling so lovely about yourself. When you're at your highest point, you've come to the mountaintop, you sat in one position for 1 hour, and you didn't eat all afternoon, and you thought to yourself, I'm so radiant, and I'm so clean now. I'm going to just give it all up. I'm never going to hate ever again. And then you get down the mountain, and the next thing that happens is somebody cuts you off on the road, and you're like, nah. I know, I see all of you. I know what it's like. Hey, I hate things too. Anger is not something that you have to avoid. It's not a good thing to hold inside yourself. It's not a good thing to act like you don't do it. The people who are trying to be the most holy are often the people who are doing some of the worst damage. And I find that the people who are the most holy are often the people who have been through the most shit. Suffering is unpleasant. Yes, it is. But people who can achieve balance in their suffering are of a higher caliber than people who cannot. This is true. And this is why I love motherfuckers in the hood. I love me some raw ass salty people who don't give a good goddamn what you think. They'll slap you upside your head. You can eat a bowl of dicks with your little paltry think you know everything about spiritual light, wisdom, and love. You don't. You don't know about suffering. So suffer it to be so that some of you will think more about this thing. Suffer it to be so that you will not cause suffering amongst others, but that you will bear it with them. Suffer it to be so that when you do cause suffering amongst others, that you just breathe it in, breathe it out, make amends. Fix it. Forgive. Forget. Get over it. Make it right. Some of you are thinking, I can't do that. Whatever I've done is too much. It's too bad. It's too terrible. It's gone too far. You haven't even started. It's a long journey out of purgatory, people. If you don't start walking, you're not going to get there anytime soon. Sooner than later. It may take forever, but as long as you walk in. So many of you out there, you're thinking, oh shit, well, I'm fucked. I've done too many bad things. You can always fix it tomorrow, right? Because you're going to start doing the next day a new way. That's how it works. That's how it works. If you don't like the way the world is, change. If you don't like the way your life is, change. If you don't like the way things are, change. Change yourself. Don't ask other people to change. Don't say, oh, the whole world has to change for me. Change yourself to what you want to be. Change yourself to what is best. This is the way. This is the way. the message of the Maitreya is always going to be the same. I am Kalki, Krishna Cross. You don't know me and you don't need to. I'm a program. I'm not a person. The face, who's this guy? Who's the dude? Who cares? Fuck him. He doesn't matter. If I come to you and I let you help, great. I'll give you everything I have. Don't worship anything about the person. There are a million Buddhas, and every one of them is an impediment to him. You cannot base it off the thing, but you cannot throw the things away. You have to find balance in your suffering.